Hi everybody, I'm Dan Schulman, the CEO of PayPal, and it's my pleasure today to be with Steven Caesar and Lisa Paletti. Welcome both of you.
Thank you. Thanks for having us.
Thank you. Steven and Lisa, in addition to their roles here at PayPal, also are the co-chairs of Amplify, which is our diversity and inclusion community for Black employees here at PayPal. So maybe what we can do is start off, and both of you can tell me a little bit about your roles here at PayPal. And also as the global co-chairs of Amplify, maybe how that experience has impacted your time here at PayPal as well.
I've been here for 6 years now. Yeah. And during that time, Amplify hadn't even begun. So it's been fantastic to see it start from its beginning when it was just an idea, yeah, and really to where it is today, where we are, you know, we have like 300 and some odd people involved in our affinity groups. We do programming every single month. There's been a whole host of different things that the each one of the sites have worked on, and it's been fantastic to see it really grow.
That's great. Steven?
Yes, so I have been with PayPal for 4 years, and this is my first year as the co-chair, yeah, for Amplify. And it's just really amazing to see the journey. I joined Amplify when I initially joined PayPal. There wasn't really a Black employee network until 2.5 years ago. And it's just amazing to see the journey over the last couple of years. It's really fascinating to see how people are able to connect on that level, but not just within a Black employee network, Amplify, but also with the other affinity groups. And last year we did quite a bit of work trying to pull together our resources with Aliados and even with Pride. And that is gonna be a focus for us going into 2020. It's amazing to see the ability that we have to bring in good talent and to also focus on developing the talent that we have within the company. And that to me brings me so much joy and very excited to see how where we take this.
Yeah, that's great to hear. It's been, I think now, 2.5 years since Amplify was founded. Can you maybe both talk a little bit about that journey, how it's evolved, what we've accomplished, and sort of as you look forward into 2020, what are you most excited about? Maybe Steve, I can start with you on that.
Yes, I think for me, the most exciting thing is just having the executive sponsorship. Yeah. I think last year we didn't quite have that. We had VP leaders that continued to be very dedicated to Amplify, but now we have Leah Sweet, who is our executive sponsor, and we are already engaged with her. Our goals for 2020 is to ensure that, one, we are focusing on talent, recruit from a recruiting perspective, mm-hmm, but also growing the talent that we have here at PayPal. We also want to focus on partnerships internally with other affinity groups. And then we want to focus on partnerships externally, so outside of PayPal. Yeah. There are amazing organizations out there that are doing great work, and I think it's great if we can pull our ideas together and truly impact the community. I'm very excited about that, and that will also allow us to get the name of PayPal continue to be out there in the community, yeah, and possibly even grow their business.
Yeah, so. Exactly. That's great. Lisa, how would you add to that?
I think in the beginning, a lot of our programming was centered around Black History Month, and then, you know, it was maybe some social events after that, and yeah, now we have so much programming that we have programs that come up throughout the year, and I think that's really been a good journey for us that, you know, things don't end and stop with Black History Month, which is at the beginning of the year. Yeah. So now we'll celebrate things then during June with Juneteenth. Like Stephen was saying, we partner with our other affinity groups, and there's things we celebrate around Small Business Week, where we were working with a merchant. This happened with our team in EMEA. They did a fantastic job of bringing in some merchants into our site there and really educating them on PayPal products. And that puts our name out there to the merchants, as well as give us an opportunity to sell those merchants, especially in an environment where we may not have been in the past with, yeah, a lot of these diverse merchant. And it really goes to the crux of financial inclusion, which is something I know you feel passionate about.
Great.
And we are going to take it a step further, not just focus on merchants, but other organizations outside of PayPal. So, for example, the New York Urban League, youth organization is a true partner to us. And we spent time last year bringing the students in and coaching them on how to work on resumes, how to truly become informed from a financial standpoint. And we intend on taking that forward in 2020 and also partnering with other organizations like Posse, which is a really renowned organization outside of PayPal.
And just to add one thing to Stephen's point, we're also trying to create playbooks as we go and do these things so that it's not just in EMEA, that it can easily be translated to our other sites. And whenever someone comes up with a program, we try to take all of those great ideas and make sure the other sites know about them so that they can have that programming there as well.
Oh, that's great. That's great. I know one of the things that you're also focused on is how do we do mentorship, recruiting, interns. How do we recruit from historically Black colleges, universities? Can you talk a little bit about that programming, what your goals and aspirations are for that?
We started with, basically here in San Jose, with bringing in interns a few days early, where there's one leader or one person who's going to work with that intern, just to make sure that they're acclimated, that they understand how PayPal works, that they know that there's somebody, you know, who will listen to them if they have any struggles when they first start. What's also fantastic about it this year is we're bringing in Aliados, and I think we're going to name it Aliados now, and partner with them so that we have a host of interns. Another thing that I'm really excited about is the working with the HBCUs. It's something that our membership got really, really excited about. It really kind of activated them. They all signed up to help us and help university recruiting. And where I am in Timonium, there's a lot of HBCUs surrounding our campus, and this is where we see that there's an opportunity to really reach out to them, become connected, and really start creating this nice connection between the university and us so that we can recruit and retain employees a lot better.
Yeah, fantastic.
Yeah, and also on the issue of mentorship programs, I think that is there's been a huge appetite for that, even for our employees here at PayPal. And so we've been exploring, especially in the New York office, we've been exploring opportunities to truly build that out and create that program. And I know other affinity groups like, I think, Unity has a very formal and really robust mentorship program. And so we are going to kind of learn from them and see how we can tailor that to our organization. So not only are we going to focus on bringing in diverse talent, but we're going to focus on growing the talent and developing the talent that we already have here at PayPal to create them, create opportunities for them.
It's so exciting to see all that Amplify's done and our other D&I communities are doing as well. I do want to just take one moment and thank both of you. You have full-time jobs. They're demanding jobs. They're incredibly important jobs here at PayPal. And you take the time to co-chair and lead one of our major D&I communities. So on behalf of everyone at PayPal, thank you for everything you do for us, for our customers, and for our various inclusive communities. So thanks, and again, thanks for spending the time with me too.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you, Stephen. Thank you, Lisa.
Thank you.